But the whole thing is a lie. If you were to assemble a list, a hierarchy of concerns, of problems this country faces, where would white supremacy be on the list?
Rhino, you're so stupid, nigga.
Stupid?
You will not replace us!
Say it again. Say it again. Say it again.
Whatever.
Get out of here.
No, I'm not gonna get out of here.
Girl, I got you.
Ma'am,
you're in my space. I'm girl, white.
Right up there with Russia, probably. It's actually not a real problem in America.
You will not replace us!
I don't know why you hate us. Why do you hate us?
Go back to wherever the
f-
you come from, lady.
The combined membership of every white supremacist organization in this country would be able to fit inside a college football stadium? I mean, seriously. White supremacy, that's the problem. This is a hoax. Just like the Russia hoax, it's a conspiracy theory used to divide the country and keep a hold on power. That's exactly what's going on.
Tucker, come on, fam. This is the hill you want to die on? A hoax? Like how Donald Trump labeled global warming?
The searing sun turning the earth into a tinderbox, leaving the ground cracked by drought.
Is journalistic malpractice. Tucker foregoes more than 175 people dying in at least 16 high-profile attacks linked to white nationalism around the world since 2011. There is a rise in white supremacy-based attacks. Case in point, the influence through which Tucker cheerleads every evening on Fox News, his president, where the El Paso Killers Manifesto mentions the same verbiage not only 45 uses, but also Tucker freaking Carlson. Ask Mario Balotelli about the white nationalism ideology.
For a little bit. Alone. If it's gonna happen one more time, I'm gonna leave the pitch.
Or Doug Glanville of NBC Chicago.
Especially when you think back and look back.
Or Russell Westbrook.
I just told him, I'm like, just sit down and ice your knees, bro. And he turned to me and he's like, that's heat, that's heat. And I'm like, well, you're gonna need it.
A man and his wife in the stands told me to get in on my knees like he used to.
Or Raheem Sterling.
The incident with Raheem Sterling yesterday is very much on our mind.
Or even our potential neighbors.
Howdy, I'm Parker Mushroom, and I hate black people. They're stinky, and they just suck. If you notice over there is a box of Jordans. The favorite pair of shoes for a black man. I'm gonna show you what I think of a black man.
If this is a hoax, Tucker, why did a former FBI assistant director say this?
Our chief executive is seen as almost a mentor and a radicalizer. And unfortunately, today, we did not hear what we needed to hear from that person that these extremists and unstable people look to. So what happens is the extremists interpret what the president read off a script today as something he needed to say. Something he didn't really want to say.
However, there is a reason why Tucker spews this nonsense. Like Trump and Missionary with Stormy Daniels, it's Tucker's base.
Boom. Roasted.
The Anti-Defamation League calculates that 73.3% of U.S. extremist-related murders in the past decade were committed by far right-wing extremists, including white supremacists. Historian Kathleen Ballou is here to educate. Too many people still think of these attacks as single events rather than interconnected actions, like this confused David Duke wannabe. We spend too much ink dividing them into anti-immigrant, racist, anti-Muslim, anti-Semitic attacks. True, they are these things. But they are also connected with one another through a broader white power ideology. NBC News reported via the ADL, extremist-related murders spiked 35% from 2017 to 2018, making them responsible for more deaths than in any year since 1995. Tucker's ideology on the subject matches the same mindset of a white supremacist. In an op-ed via USA Today, R. Derek Black wrote, I grew up a white nationalist. We never blamed ourselves for mass shootings like El Paso. Deflection is the key to open the locks of white supremacy. The only way to limit this idiot's rhetoric is to hit where it hurts the most. The pockets of Tucker and Fox News. Here are his advertisers. Let your own true feelings be heard about white supremacy's terrorism.